Charles I Robert died on the 16th of July, 1342. The throne was inherited by his oldest son, Louis I the Great, d'Anjou. Louis' succession passed almost without a single problem. There was some disquiet and discontent among the infighting Croatian lords of the houses of Šubić and Nelipić, but they quickly quieted down when Louis led an army down to demonstrate who the boss was. And to strengthen his strategic position in Dalmatia and Croatia, Louis got them to hand over several important castles to him. But because members of the families cooperated with Louis, they were compensated for them with land elsewhere. In 1347, as compensation for the loss of their most important fortress of Ostrovica, which was protecting the central familial holding of Bribir itself, one part of the Šubić dynasty received the castle of Zrin in Slavonia, splitting the Šubić family into the Šubić-Zrinski branch and the Šubić-Bribirski. The stability in the realm allowed Louis to do what every medieval king with unquestioned authority does: take an interest in hunting, building libraries, supporting art, and most importantly, go on military campaign every single year of his reign. You see, the purpose of taking these castles was to strengthen the power of the king in strategically important areas. This was important for Louis's upcoming military endeavors. The primary matter that caught Louis's attention at the start of his reign was his own familial split, that is to say, the succession in the Kingdom of Naples. When King Robert of Naples died in 1343, in his will he left his granddaughter Joan as sole heir to the kingdom, and she relegated her husband and cousin Andrew, the brother of Louis, to the lowly position of Duke of Calabria. This in effect broke the agreement that was made by Charles Robert and Joan's grandfather Robert that Andrew should inherit the kingdom. Neither Joan or the court of Naples liked Andrew. Even though he was family, he was too Hungarian, not at all to their tastes. So much so that Joan was having an open affair with the princes of Tarento, also her cousins. As King Louis and his mother Elizabeth were managing to convince the Pope to make a ruling on the legitimacy of the succession in Andrew's favor, the whole matter reached a dead end in 1345, when Andrew was found dead in Aversa, assassinated through defenestration and strangulation. After the killing of his brother, Louis was angry. He personally considered the whole branch of the family that ruled in Naples responsible for Andrew's murder. Louis wanted the Pope to put Joan on trial and give the crown of Naples to him. But the Pope was very unwilling to grant Louis's demands, as the investigation into Andrew's murder gave no conclusive evidence as to who the culprit was. While this was all going on, Louis had spent time at war with Venice. The war conveniently coincided with that previously mentioned army of his arriving in Dalmatia and Croatia. The city of Zadar rebelled against Venice and declared loyalty to Louis. Venice put Zadar under siege, and Louis personally charged to its defense in 1346, and he was defeated, leading to Venice taking back the city. But with that over with, Louis had decided to take the matter of Naples into his own hands. In 1347, he marched on Naples with a big army, but was forced to take the overland route, as most of the coast was still under control of Venice. At the sight of his brother's murder in Aversa, Louis summoned some of the members of his family. He put them under arrest and had his cousin Charles of Durazzo executed on the spot. Needless to say that this act did not make Louis popular in Naples. Louis soon took the crown of Naples for himself in January of 1348. Within 3 months, he was forced to return to the realm of St. Stephen. The plague, the Black Death, had appeared. It had destroyed entire villages, closed up entire towns, killed quite a few of the nobility of the realm, including Louis's young wife, Queen Margaret of Bohemia, and sent the realm into short-term chaos. Though the plague was less devastating on the more dispersed and sparsely populated Eastern Europe than the more heavily populated Central and Western Europe, there were still heavy losses when the plague arrived in any place. These events forced Louis to sign an 8-year peace with Venice, and as soon as Louis had left Naples in 1348, Joan sauntered back into the kingdom with little to no trouble and reclaimed her throne. In 1349, Louis sent a mercenary army under the voivode of Transylvania, Stephen Lacfay, to seize back the kingdom, but that campaign proved to be a disaster. Having secured a transport deal with Venice in 1350, Louis led another expedition and drove Joan out of the kingdom, again, but soon realized that he would be unable to hold on to it, again, as people didn't exactly like him. Louis returned to Hungary, again, and Joan recaptured her kingdom, again. Louis and Joan finally made peace in 1352, and Louis gave up his claims on Naples and released the rest of the family he had put under arrest. This Neapolitan adventure was a disaster, and Louis had other matters to deal with.